In this video, you will learn how to make a question and answer tab for the WooCommerce product page without any plugins. In the answer section, you can use plain text, tables, images, and other HTML tags. You can also write separate questions and answers for each product or product category. For example, on the t-shirt page, the t-shirt size table is displayed, and on the hoodie page, the hoodie size table is displayed. Let's get started. Go to the link in the description. Copy this PHP code. On the WordPress dashboard, go to Appearance, Theme File Editor and open the functions.php file. As you can see, I am using the Bloxy child theme. You must create a child theme before making any changes to functions.php. Otherwise, the applied changes will be lost after each update. Watch video number 1 on the channel to learn how to make a child theme. Paste the code into the functions.php and update the file. Let's go to the shop page and open one of the products. As you can see, the question and answer tab has been added, along with 2 sample questions. Return to the theme editor. You can change the title of the tab by changing the tab's title variable. Update the file and check the result. Go back to the theme editor. In this section, you can enter your questions and answers. I have already prepared a number of questions and answers that I will use. If you need more questions and answers, just copy the details tag. Update the file and check the result. As you can see, the questions and answers we entered into the functions.php file will be displayed in all products. To add questions and answers only to a specific product, go to the Edit Product page. In the Screen Options section, make sure that the Custom Fields option is turned on. Create a new field in the Custom Fields section and name it QA. In the value, enter the question or title. Then hit the Enter button and go to the next line and write the answer. I will again use the question and answer I prepared earlier. Now click on the Add Custom Field button and go to the product page to see the result. You can see the new question we entered here. You can enter more questions and answers by adding more custom fields. Now we enter the t-shirt size table in the custom fields. I will copy the HTML table code from here. In the following, I will teach you how to make this table using WordPress Gutenberg. Just paste the copied HTML code here and update the custom fields. You can see, the size table has been successfully added. To create a size table using Gutenberg, create a new page. Now add a table block and enter your desired values in it. Finally, copy this table and paste it into custom fields. Now click on the Add Custom Field button and go to the product page to see the result. You can see the table we made with Gutenberg here. To place an image in the answer section, first add an image block. Insert your desired image into it and adjust its size as desired. Finally, copy this image and paste it into the new custom fields. Now click on the Add Custom Field button and go to the product page to see the result. As you can see, the image has been added successfully. Suppose we want to put the size table in the question and answer tab for two categories, t-shirt and hoodie, and the size tables of these two categories are different. To do this, we must use conditional tags. In video number 7 of the channel, we have fully explained how to use conditional tags. Go to the description link of video number 7. Now go to Insert PHP code in Pages with Given Terms section. Copy this code snippet. Now we have to write an if condition. Paste the code we copied earlier here. In this section, we have to put the category slug. Now the questions and answers that we write here will be displayed only for t-shirts. I have already prepared a t-shirt size chart that I will use. Update the file. Now, if you open the hoodies, you will not see the table. And if you open the page of a t-shirt, you will see the size table. Now we repeat the same steps for hoodies. Here, we put the hoodie category slug. Now the questions and answers that we write here will be displayed only for hoodies. Update the file. If you refresh the product page of a hoodie, you will see the hoodie size table. And if you open the product page of a t-shirt, you will see the t-shirt size table. That's it! If you do have any questions or comments about this, please put them below. If you liked this video and would like to see more like it, please subscribe, and I'll see you next time.